Hi, I'm Tammy T. Patton, one of your Clinton Township trustees. Welcome to my show, where I talk one-on-one to the men and women who answer the call every day when there's an emergency or when you need help. During our conversations, you'll learn more about these first responders than where they went to school or how they train. So join me now for Talking with Tammy T. I have before me Deputy Chief Chuck Van Horlbach, as well as Officer Adam Hackstock. And you guys are doing something pretty cool, and you're looking to let the public know about it ahead of time, just so they can hold this date. But I'm going to let you talk about it, because this is your project. So one of you can start.
Thanks for having us. Yeah, in 2018, we had a Battle of the Badges charity softball game played at Chippewa Valley between our department and the police department. It was a huge success, made over $5,000 for charity. Obviously, with the pandemic, we took a couple years off. Our intent was to have it every year, but we took a couple years off because of COVID. So with COVID kind of subsiding a little bit, we decided to have the event again this year. But this year, we're going to have it at Jimmy John's Field on September 25th between 6 and 10 p.m. at night. In addition to the police department, we're also going to invite Sterling Heights Fire Department and their police department to play us in a four-team softball tournament.
So you guys are battling each other along with Sterling Heights?
Yeah, they'll have their own team. We'll have our own team as well as them, and it'll be a fun night.
So we're looking at four teams going through this whole
thing? Yeah, it'll be over a couple hours.
Okay.
Yeah.
So does the two winning teams play each other?
Yep. Winner of the first two games will play in the championship game, and the losers of the two first games will play in another game that evening.
Who do you think is going to lose? No, I'm just kidding.
Who's going to lose?
No, I'm just kidding. Who do you think those winning teams would be? Fire, and police? No.
Yeah.
Okay.
We want to make it a little bit bigger and, a little bit better this time around. And Jimmy John's offered up their field to us. And
very nice.
Yeah, it'll be nice.
So how many seats do they have over at Jimmy John's for you guys?
A little over 2,000.
So you need to fill every seat.
Yeah, that would be fantastic.
And what's the fundraiser for, though?
This time, we are going to, all the funds will go towards a first responder bronze statue to be displayed here at the township offices. It'll be a firefighter and a police officer holding a little child's hand on a granite pedestal, and that'll be something that will be displayed at the township offices that can be enjoyed for years to come, okay. You know, honoring past and present first responders here in the township.
So you're looking at raising enough funds to have this completely done by just donations?
Donations, right? Sponsorships, ticket sales.
And you guys want to start this project by when? Or have it at the township by when? Have it erected by the when?
Obviously, it all depends on how much funds are raised, but, you know, probably the next year or so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And what date is it again?
September 25th.
That's
it's a Sunday night. We'll be playing Under the Lights. Starts at 6. Full concession stands, mascots, tons of stuff for the kids, emergency vehicles on display, kinds of good stuff.
How much are the tickets?
Tickets will be $10 a person. And 10 and under, $5.
Okay. And then what about parking?
Parking would be $5 a car.
Very good. Do you guys need volunteers?
Yes, that would be fantastic. Volunteers to help with concessions, parking cars, just general help around the around the facility there.
We're in the process of trying to figure out how we can organize it so we can get volunteers that want to participate to sign up.
Okay.
We're putting together areas that we might need some help. And once we get that, we'll put that back out.
Very good. And then for the tickets, though, you guys are going to use Eventbrite. So it's going to be pre-sale tickets so that we know where everyone's sitting, how many tickets are sold.
Yeah, we'll get the Eventbrite sent out to everybody, and then also tickets can be purchased at the night at the door also.
And that'll be down the line a little bit.
Yeah.
Right. Okay. Is anything else you'd like to let us know? How many are we looking per team? I know it's baseball, but like how many... You know, Sterling Heights is also part of this, right? But they understand that the fundraiser is for Clinton Township, so they're donating their time.
Yeah, I talked to a friend of mine that works at Sterling and told them that, you know, we more or less would like them to come out and just kind of participate in it. Every year, the intention is moving forward to bring out a different city. for the fundraiser at the hopefully at Jimmy John's again. So this year is Sterling's turn. Next year we'll address us again and see where we're at. But I'm pretty sure we're gonna win.
What'd you say, Adam? I didn't hear you.
You got that on tape.
Pretty sure. Who's gonna win? Was it the
Clinton Police?
Oh, okay.
Pretty sure
okay.
We got this.
Pretty sure. Okay. All right. Are you guys going to sell any type of T-shirts for people who want to support one? Or is it going to be a half and half T-shirt?
We're looking at
in case you want police and fire.
We're making a Battle of the Badges T-shirt to be sold at the event.
Okay.
There's plenty of opportunity to be to donate sponsorships. Also, tables can be available that night too for vendors that want to sponsor a table. They can put out their own goods for display and. Lots of options.
Will there be a cap on vendors in terms of how, and I know this is probably down the line, but will you guys end up having a cap on how many vendors you'll have out?
Yeah, potentially okay. Based on space.
And then
yeah.
You'll let us know later about the price of the tables as well. Okay.
We're in the process of getting the flyer done right now. Mm-hmm. Eventually that flyer will end up on a Facebook page that we'll put out for Clinton Township residents as well as for the Sterling Heights mm-hmm. residents. That may want to come out as well, so that'll be coming down the road.
Will there be food?
Concession stands will be open, okay. Just like going to a regular ball game. It'll be nice.
Very good. Yep. And that's going to all be volunteers working the concession stands.
Yes.
And we're going to need those donations as well.
Yeah, food donations, drink donations, volunteers.
Very good.
Yep.
Okay. Anything else you guys want to add? Are you talking to the community to let them know?
Just want to say this is going to be a nice event, and it'd be fantastic to have a large turnout. And if you're able to come out that night, we'd love to see you. It'll be fun. It's for a good cause.
It's going to be a good time. We're all going to have fun. We're all going to enjoy it, and we just hope to see everybody out there.
Absolutely. The more the merrier. So thank you guys
for coming in.
Letting us know about what's going on. It's a great fundraiser, and you're shooting for 2,000, right?
Yes.
Yes, all 2,000. Yeah. That's where we're all the way up here.
Let's pack the place.
We're going to pack the place. Yeah. Yes, awesome. Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.